southpaw stance on Bangpleenoi, a two-time World Muay Thai champion with 120 wins. Very heavy artillery being launched and Brown takes a shot south of the border. Maybe recovery time here for the Dutchman.
Bangpleenoi looks sharp, staying a little bit loose. Nice and relaxed. I think we are ready to go underway.
Bangpleenoi is known for his kick attacks and his elbow attacks. Loves to attack the body. Look for the roundhouse kicks to the ribs, also the liver section. He's in southpaw stance here, the two-time world champion. Wild uppercut, almost took out the ring lights. Nice roundhouse kick off the back leg there from Brown. They are opening with a heavy artillery. There is no filling out process in this one. Straight right hand down the tube from Brown.
It's curious to see how Brown is going to utilize that reach advantage. I would expect a lot more jabs to start coming off him, but he's trading power shots with Bangpleenoi.
A two-time European kickboxing champion, Brown, on the right of screen. Catches the roundhouse kick. Nice evasion there from Bangpleenoi. Bangpleenoi, a master of Muay Thai, which is the beautiful style, the aesthetic style of Muay Thai. Although this is a power-charged opening round on the two-time world champ. Takes the roundhouse kick off the back leg of Bangpleenoi. Edges forward now the time. Inside thigh kick from Brown. Jab to overhand elbow from Bangpleenoi came agonizing the close match.
Now, Muay Thai is a little bit different from a lot of other styles of Muay Thai, Michael. Can you explain that a little bit to people at home?
It relies more on the aesthetics. You see guys like Godzilla, who get top team. He's another master of Muay Thai. So it's Muay Thai. It's just the more classic, beautiful, aesthetic to watch style of Muay Thai, rather than all that sheer brute power. Nice evasion there. Don't forget, these two men are competing in 4 ounce gloves. You talk about adding power to the most powerful striking art in the world of martial arts. 4 ounce gloves takes it on a whole other level, Dragon.
And it does. And you can hear the thuds from all around cage side. They just land so much more impactful. Like, you just hear the thud. And that is the difference in these world-class strikers getting put in 4 ounce gloves. That one looked like it was the top of the thigh.
That was pretty much a mirror image of the first groin kick. Exactly the same technique, going for the inside thigh, high on the thigh, trying to hit the femoral profunda. It slips up a little too high and just connects Brown. He's okay to go on here. It's always very awkward when you're competing against a southpaw in that region. Generally can get attacked quite a lot. It's just what happens when you compete against a southpaw and you're an orthodox.
Especially if you like the low kicks, if you like going after the legs, the only option you really have, unless you're switching to the right kick on the outside of the thigh, is to go on that inside thigh. And you see the leg length of Brown is just so vast that it's he's just coming up a little bit too high on it.
Final seconds of what has been a cracking opening round. One way to kick off one championship hero's ascent.
Round two.
Go.
Roundhouse kick there from Bangpleenoi. Brown measuring with the lead hand. Fires a tip to the midsection. Cracking roundhouse again. Triple there from Bangpleenoi. Trying to close the distance. Catch of the front, he just upends him. Left hook there from Brown, needed a right hand for company. Bangpleenoi goes upstairs again, trying to break down that that right forearm of Brown.
He's doing that. You start to see a little bit of the swelling start to build up there on Brown because he's eaten so many of those shots to that forearm.
A lot of you who may be watching Muay Thai here for the first time may be thinking, well, those kicks of Bangpleenoi aren't scoring. They're being caught in the forearms by Brown. Well, that's the game plan, folks. You break down the forearm, you continually hit it with those terribly powerful roundhouse kicks, and the arms fall. Then you come over the top with a roundhouse kick to the head. A third illegal groin strike there from Bangpleenoi. Now, I wonder what stage referee Omar is going to show a yellow card.
Show a yellow card, but that's three times that Bangpleenoi has went down south.
Now, Mitch, I will say they've all been accidental. None of them are intentional. It's not malicious at all, but it's happened three times.
But you can see that it's going straight up into the body. It's not going to the thigh. I mean, the thighs of Brown are extremely long, so he was going right up into the body there, and it just went up into the groin. Maybe he's used to throwing body kicks on shorter opponents, so that's why it's going down low. But you can see that if he wants to go after the legs, he could go after the legs, especially with that angle that we just got shown here.
Go!
As I said, it's problematic and unorthodox. Takes on the southpaw. There's another kick to the forearms by Bangpleenoi, and another.
With only three rounds, Michael, if Bangpleenoi gets a point taken away, that could cost him the match.
So the injury time, we should note as well, is accumulating, which means Bangpleenoi against Brown only has 1 minute of injury time remaining should he get struck again in the region. Outside leg kick here from Bangpleenoi. That's the money shot. That's the bread and butter for Bangpleenoi. Cracking away that right forearm of Brown. Now he's got to let his hands go over the top. Can't sit just enough to get to the midsection. And again, Bangpleenoi. Roundhouse kick, followed by a hook. The hook missed the target. Now I'm not pulling the trigger as much as we saw him last time against Johan Fertig's Dry. Now he knocked out Dry around this time in the second round back in November with a spinning elbow. Mine, it was the knockout of the year in 2018. It was spectacular. Could he possibly do it again? And cause what would be considered by many to be an upset, because Bangpleenoi is a two-time world champion.
Might see Bangpleenoi start utilizing those hands a little bit more. Throw those hands and then do some combination. Because right now, all he's doing is throwing that left kick to the arm of Brown. Again, it's definitely there. It's slowing down Brown, but is that doing anything else with it except just taking on his arm?
Have a look how Bangpleenoi controls center cage here, keeping ground to the outside. High lift roundhouse kick, tried to loop the shin around the back of the head. Final 10 seconds of this second stanza. High kick to the face there from Brown. Fakes the right cross. Backs out of the way. Beautifully done. End of the second. One more to go.
Final round.
A two-time world champion, Bangpleenoi. A two-time European champion, Brown Pinas. Good right hand down the tube there from Brown to open up the third round. And he lands another right hand smack bang to the nose of Bangpleenoi. Bangpleenoi probing with the jab, the southpaw. Now don't forget, public enemy number one of a southpaw is the straight right hand. But to enable that right cross, Brown needs to put his lead foot on the outside of Bangpleenoi's lead foot.
These are the ki, I guess you would call it, from Bangpleenoi. Every time he throws a big shot, he just kind of emphasizes it with a big oi.
Now, what we often hear the ki corners do as well, when they fight a Lanza technique, they'll shout, ooh-ay! And that's for two reasons. One is to encourage their fighter and say, yep, you landed, it was a good one. The second, and more importantly, is to appeal to the judges, to put an exclamation mark on the technique, to let the judges hear that it's landed. And the more they're hearing the ooh-ay from the corner, the more the judges are really thinking, well, that's landed, that's scored the points.
I don't know if R1 championship judges would be swayed by a loud ki, but I guess it works in Thailand.
It's a very old Muay Thai technique from the corners. And if you ever attend one of the stadiums in Thailand and watch some Muay Thai, it's like a soundtrack to the event. Unofficially, I do have Brown trailing, and he gets knocked down with a left hand there. That being the cross of the southpaw, and that's going to make Brown trail even further now. That was exquisite from Bangpleenoi. The timing, the precision on that left cross of the southpaw.
Left hand penetrated right through the defense of Brown and caught him right on the button as he stumbled back down. This is Bangpleenoi's chance.
Unofficially again, I would have gone 10-9 first and second rounds to Bangpleenoi. As it stands here in the third, it'll be a 10-8 round for Bangpleenoi because he does have that knockdown on Brown.
You can see Brown kind of shuffle down there. He was looking at the spinning back elbow. He was hoping for Bangpleenoi to rush forward, but the two-time world champion was not falling for it.
This time, last time out, Brown had knocked out Johan Fertig's Dry, who is considered the best Westerner competing out of Thailand. But he is seeing that Bangpleenoi Pit India Academy is a whole different kettle of fish, a whole different breed of Muay Thai monster. And a Can he find something special in the final 25 seconds, the Dutchman? Two-time European champion and also two-time world champion. There's the spinning back elbow from Brown. And Bangpleenoi just smiled at him. He saw it coming. He read it well. It's going to take something miraculous to get through Bangpleenoi's defense. It's Bangpleenoi moments away from his first ever one Super Series victory. He may very well be.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Bangpleenoi.
Southpaw starts, and Bangpleenoi also in southpaw starts.
Nice combination thrown by Nolan so far. Says he really wants to utilize that push kick off the right leg. Really just make sure he finds his distance and his range. And also, that push kick is also going to be a nice counter to that left kick thrown by Bangpleenoi.
A real gym specialty, that push kick. You see it on former world champion Jonathan Haggerty, training partner of Liam Nolan. Jab to crossing elbow there from Nolan. Nice front kick to the midsection. Outside of the kick from Bangpleenoi.
Haggerty utilizes that push kick beautifully. Lots of fakes just like that. You saw that in his last matchup against Rod Tang. Liam Nolan's doing a good job utilizing that push kick, especially right there, stomping on the leg of Bangpleenoi.
Big hooking punch off the right glove there from Bangpleenoi. Jab to Nolan, gets countered down the center corridor. Tip to the thigh there from Nolan, outside leg kick from Bangpleenoi. Both men are loading the power early. There's no filling out process. You can't do so under these one Super Series Muay Thai rules, only 3x3. Inside the circle with the front kicks here. Liam Nolan from the UK. Nice whipping roundhouse kick there, switched up on it. Another switch kick there from Nolan, then goes off the left leg. Body shot from Bangpleenoi. Lots of instructions coming from the Pekindi corner. Good front kick from Nolan again, Dragon.
A good job of putting out that jab as well. Just kind of a little range finder thrown by Nolan. This is his opportunity. This first round is very important. Bangpleenoi is known to kind of have a slow start in these first rounds. And this could be an easy little jump ahead for Nolan on the scorecards.
Thought about the clinch is permitted under these Muay Thai rules. So long as you stay busy in the clinch. Good cutting side kick there from Bangpleenoi.
Beautiful push kick right there. Bangpleenoi slipped right through the
thigh.
Nice kick.
That combination, left hook to an inside thigh kick. Now they clinch up, and referee Elias Delapsis breaks them.
30 seconds left in the first round.
Sensational first round. The speed on those switch kicks of Nolan and the power-laden technique of Bangpleenoi. Oh, Nolan drops him with a left hand. No knockdown there. Oh, that was a good left hand from Nolan. Thought about a front kick, sticks the jab in the face. Fake there from Nolan. Into the first round, we go to the towels. Combination work early here from Liam Nolan. Switch round kick again from the Brits. Right hook to an outside leg kick from Bangpleenoi. Body shot from Nolan. Tried for the crossing elbow. There's an uppercut elbow. Crossing elbow from Nolan. Looking to slice and dice here, the man from the UK.
Leg kick by Bangpleenoi. Starting to find a home on that right leg of Liam Nolan. Nolan's got to start checking some of these. Throws it with such heat too. That's leg kick.
Men in southpaw stance. Body shot from Bangpleenoi. Had some mustard behind it. Front kick from Nolan. Needs to come over the top for company. Tries for the elbow. looking for the bridge of the nose. Bangpleenoi continues to tenderize the legs of Nolan. Switch kick again from the 22-year-old. You can see the reddening on the inside and outside thighs of Nolan.
Bangpleenoi's going a lot to that switch left, that switch right kick. I think he's trying to utilize that body shot, trying to find a home for that left, that right kick on the body of Liam Nolan.
Chab looking for the big tough thump into the outside legs again. There was Bangpleenoi. Skips across the center circle, gloves up high, nice evasion from the tie.
Start to see some of that superficial damage right there in the leg of Liam Nolan.
Bangpleenoi, India Academy, only 25 years old, with more than 180 career bouts. He's a two-division WNC Muay Thai world champion.
Nice counter there by Bangpleenoi as he slipped the hook, came across with the left.
Crossing elbow. Can Team Thailand get off to a winning start in Bangkok tonight, courtesy of Bangpleenoi?
Good job of catching the kicks and countering.
Checks the low kick to Nolan. Jab in the right hand of the southpaw. Throw that left, maybe wants to go to the inside and throw left his elbow here, Nolan. Deep kick to the thigh. Switch round kick again from Nolan.
Nice though by Bangpleenoi as he moves back. Avoids it.
Cracking roundhouse kick. Nolan just managed to bring up the forearm in time.
That's it.
Scintillating this contest. Outside leg kick from Nolan. And that's another round down. Two rounds down, one to go. Expecting a sellout inside the massive Impact Arena in Bangkok for one championship dreams of gold. Second round of this one Super Series Muay Thai clash.
I don't know, Michael, what do you think? Does it come down to this third round? Even?
Trade of kicks again. Third and final here. Is it one round apiece at the moment? Did Nolan get the first? Did Bangpleenoi get the second? Three judges circle side. Oh, jumping roundhouse. Beautiful switch on that from Nolan.
Nice there. Now he's starting to go. Now he's starting to utilize that left kick a lot more.
Three judges circle side is scoring on a 10-point must system. The winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points.
Beautiful combination to the right hook, the leg kick. He goes outside, then he goes inside with it.
Outside leg kick again from Bangpleenoi. It's like a target pointed on the air. The quadriceps of Liam Nolan, jumping knee, catching counter from Bangpleenoi. The oohs and the ahs and the gnashing of teeth here from the Thai fans in Bangkok for Bangpleenoi.
You can see the distance that these two are competing at. These guys really haven't even left that one logo. They're just kind of staying in the middle of the circle going at it. Nice fake from Nolan. He's got to keep going back to that. Throwing that push kick out, slow down that lead leg.
1 minute 30 remains, halfway through the third and final round. Just the roundhouse kick to Bangpleenoi, so too Nolan goes downstairs, gets upended. The Thais are loving this performance from Bangpleenoi. Cracking roundhouse, tries to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Nolan gloves up high, maybe that left rib exposed a little though. Bangpleenoi, nice guard, high guard, put the shin right up and tucked the elbow to the top of the thigh. Good evasion and counter there from Nolan. He knows it. There's a little shimmy.
See, Bangpleenoi's actually, you know, now he's going back to the right side. You can see him change stances. He's setting up that right kick. Little skip in there, inside leg kick from Nolan.
Breaking roundhouse kick again from Bangpleenoi. I know that Chris over in Bolton, England, watching on YouTube, is enjoying the performance so far from the man from the UK, Liam Nolan. 25 seconds to go. Oh, look for the counter elbow. That would have been genius had he landed it there, Nolan.
He's throwing some serious heat with that right kick, though. Look, he he's swinging a baseball bat attached to his hip.
Jumping roundhouse from Nolan, final 10 seconds of the contest. And it's been a rip snorter.
Very close match so far. Nolan's trying to go in that skip again.
Good match. Great sportsmanship. That martial arts spirit, that code of honor. We go down to the judges here in Bangkok.
And now, for your winner, by majority decision, from the red corner, Bangpleenoi Pregnancy Academy.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.